of the flesh, but of the Spirit, if so be it that the Spirit of Christ dwells in you. Because if the Spirit of Christ does not dwell in you, I don't care what day you go to church, how you eat, how you dress, you do not belong to Christ. But if Christ is in you, if is the key. That's our choice. That's the button that we press. If Christ is in you, then the body, the enemy, becomes dead. Because the Spirit and life and righteousness of Christ has now been invited into your body, and now it takes over every aspect of your life. I see a hand over here, and then Ray.
So does that make us prominent?
As far as God is concerned, that makes us prominent.
Correct.
So prominent does not mean you're not humble. It means you're important in the sight of God.
Only if you choose to push the button of Romans 8, 9, and 10.
Okay.
The Bible tells us that Paul was haunted by what happened
yes.
to Stephen.
Yes.
So we have to have this quality of honest of heart, right? And I think the key to what you're saying here, we've read through in Acts 7 and verse 57, it says that they cried with a loud voice, right? And they stopped their ears, right? So they don't want to hear truth, and they're screaming out because they want to hold on to their sin and their wickedness, and they don't want to. And then it even says that they ran upon him with one accord, that they were in union. I mean, this is the enemy in full work. It's absolutely amazing. And Paul was haunted by this because he was honest in heart, and that's why Jesus could turn him. Because he was stopping his ears. But when he didn't stop his ears for a moment, and he was honest in heart, he was able to see and listen and be turned, like all of us can.
So the question is how is God trying to recruit you? Is it going to take a way of Damascus experience like Stephen's to recruit you? That's a personal question you must answer. But God wants to make each one of you a person of prominence. And until you do, there's not going to be a first resurrection, which is what the Christian world is focused on. Brothers and sisters, spiritual brothers and sisters that go to church tomorrow, are focused on being resurrected. In fact, they're not even focused on being resurrected. When I say resurrected, they mean when they die right now, like they die today, they feel that they go up to heaven. With that misconception of salvation, why would they be focused on where Jesus is at today and what he's doing? Brothers and sisters, the book of Galatians is and Romans is God's version of the gospel for end time people.
Amen.
What you do with this will determine when Jesus comes back.
Amen.
Let's pray. Loving Father, thank you for the presence of your Holy Spirit and for the true word of prophecy that you have given us. We ask a special blessing on us as we study the book of Galatians to recognize the end time understanding that you want for us to have regarding this book, so that we will not be a part of delaying your second coming. We ask your continued presence with us as we go into the next service and during the waking hours of your Sabbath day, the words of our mouth and the meditation of our heart be acceptable in your sight. We thank you for answering these requests because we ask them in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.